Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. This is psychic medium Raymond Guzman, and today I'm going to be doing a psychic reading on Peter Weber. He is very handsome. He is going to be the one on The Bachelor. I think this is season 24. I'm not sure. I don't keep up with it. I don't watch The Bachelor or The Bachelorette, but I had a request for me to do a reading on The Bachelor. And so I'm going to give you the tea from Spirit on what I see about Mr. Weber. And what I see about, you know, the actual contestants that are going up to be a potential love match or interest for Mr. Weber. So if you're not familiar with The Bachelor, just to give you a little bit of background, and, you know, I don't know too much about it. I have watched maybe one episode, like the very beginning of the first or second season. But basically, it's a group of, on The Bachelor, there's a group of women that go on dates with him, you know, kind of mingle in a certain environment to see which one he's going to select as his match, okay? And there may be some money in it. I'm not sure about all that, but I'm going to give you about what I see about him. Okay, the first thing is that he is very attractive. I think that's a given. Everybody can tell he has, I think, German ancestry with mixed with some Cuban. So he's kind of, you know, has, you know, a culmination of different ancestries in him. You know, overall, is he the player type? Okay, I think that's what a lot of people want to know, because he is young still, right? You know, when I get into his soul, and genuinely, I feel like he's very very sweet guy. I feel like he's very dedicated, but he does wear a mask, okay? And I feel like for him, it's about being this kind of like Fabio, this kind of, you know, it's all about the conquest, is what I keep hearing spirits say, you know, about him getting into the minds of the ladies. And basically, we're going to see probably this season a lot of twists and turns, and probably not who he would actually pick. Now, I went through all of the contestants, and I wrote down the names of three of them that I felt there were potential matches that would be great for Peter. And these were Courtney, Kelsey, and Megan H. Those were the three top girls out of the 30 contestants or whatever that I actually saw their energy, and I think that they would, one of those girls would be great partner to Peter Weber. I see him working very hard, very dedicated after the show. I do feel like he's going to have other opportunities and maybe pursuing an acting career as well. As far as, you know, he's also like a pilot, I think, or works something in that area. And that's, you know, but I see a lot of traveling for him. I see him working very hard. I feel like there's projects that are lined up. The thing is that even though he's looking for a potential match, you know, and this is reality TV, quote unquote reality, when it comes to his true love life, like in outside of the cameras, outside of all of that, I see a lot of potential for heartbreak. I feel like there is some kind of unrequited love, quite possibly him wanting to be with someone that is not available. And so the person that would be selected as the winner of The Bachelor, I feel like there would be some pain for that young lady down the road. I don't feel like things are going to work out. And the reason I say that is because his energy is someone that is kind of confused. I feel like he knows what he wants, but at the same time, you know, the energy that surrounds him is kind of like if there was a pretty lady, you know, that walks around, you know, and she is the type that he is looking for, you know, he would definitely, I feel like, could be unloyal. It could happen. You know, he could be giving her some of his time and attention. I do feel like, you know, I feel like there is either his mother or someone else, like a female that is, you know, a sister, a friend, somebody that kind of, you know, gives him advice. And basically, I feel like they're telling him, you know, it's time to cut out all of the games, all of the tendencies that he has, you know, and really focus on establishing a family. I don't feel that he is, you know, and there's a potential. I'm not sure. I think, you know, there's a potential on the show to not even find the one. You know, he can decide that maybe there's not a match. I don't know how it goes. I think that's the way it is. But whatever the situation is, I feel like, you know, he is being told by different people, hey, dude, it's time for you to settle down. You are at a certain age. And I feel like he has high standards. While he is looking for someone you know, that is quite different from him. I also feel like he's looking for someone that is like a model. And I don't know if he's into blondes, but I keep seeing visions that, you know, that may be a type that he's into. Now, he could be into African-American women, which are very beautiful as well. I don't know. But what Spirit keeps showing me is those three women that I mentioned at the very beginning of this reading, which is Courtney, Kelsey, and Megan H. Those three have great potential to be a match for him. Now, whether he selects them or not, that's up to him. Selects one of those girls. But I feel like out of those three, those would be the most compatible with him when I tune in on a spiritual level. But I do see that he's going to be moving ahead with other projects after The Bachelor. I do feel like there is a lot of giving and taking. He's going to be a person that's very busy, managing his social life, like a lot of give and take. So whoever he chooses to be a partner or whatever love after The Bachelor that he would, you know, select, there's going to be issues in his life, because I feel like there's going to be a lot of women, obviously, that still are like gagging over him, you know, and I mean that in a good way, like they're falling all over him or very attracted to him. But I also feel like since he is going to have a lot of press after The Bachelor and be known that, you know, as the one that was on The Bachelor, of course, there's going to be a lot of focus on whether or not he's loyal, and not just that, whether or not he can kind of give his partner his undivided attention. Because the thing that we see with celebrities, because he is considered a celebrity since he is on TV, is that sometimes the work schedules are very busy, then there's a lot of socializing, and there's not enough time for the partner that they have, the partner in themselves, to spend time together, to kind of, you know, yes, they may have moments, they may have, you know, weeks on ends. Maybe they spend 2 or 3 weeks, you know, together, or a month. But then there's work, you know, and that doesn't stop. It's always on the go. So from that perspective, you know, I feel like those are some challenges for him. I also feel like even though he can be pretty emotional, he's kind of sometimes led by the superficial. And so again, this is something that he's going to have to kind of look deeply into. If he's wanting a good connection, it's going to have to be with a well-rounded individual, a woman who knows exactly what she wants and is not afraid, and is also independent, not actually, you know, someone that is going to be codependent on him, or wanting, you know, for him to kind of carry the weight financially, etc. There is a potential for him to get married, you know, within the next 2 years or less. I mean, it's very possible, but I feel like he's not going to settle right off the hand. He's very smart, like I said, very smart when it comes into selecting someone. It's very possible that he will on this show. I feel like, again, those three girls that I mentioned would be great matches, but we'll have to see how all of this plays out. For him, it's, you know, to find happiness in his love life, Spirit is saying for him to actually take a chance, take a leap of faith, choose someone that he feels attracted to, but also feels comfortable. And I do feel like one of these girls is a potential soulmate for him. Whether or not he can see that, there is a lot of energy that's going to be on the show, a lot of female energy. And so it can be very overwhelming for him on some level. You know, I don't know, in his natal chart, if he has any water sign. I think he's like a Leo. I'm not certain, but whatever his sign is, I keep getting very strong connection to a water sign in his astrological chart. Okay. In that chart, there has to be a connection to Pisces, either Pisces, Cancer, or, Scorpio. There is some kind of connection to a water sign in his chart, and I feel like that rules his emotions, it rules his intuition as well. So he's very intuitive, but I don't feel like he usually relies on his intuition and more on his hormones. And so that's what he's going to have to kind of rely more on, his intuition, if he wants to get a good match. But those three girls, one of them, you know, is a very good match. I honestly feel like the best one for him out of all of those, and I know it's kind of like hard for me to even narrow it down, but I want to say that I feel like Kelsey is a good match for him. But whether or not he sees that, or he, you know, eliminates her on the show, whatever, she gets eliminated, you know, that's to be seen. But I feel like those three girls are definitely good matches for him. And I do feel like on some personal level throughout his life, he is definitely going to fulfill his, have emotional fulfillment in his love life eventually. But I feel like it's more in his 40s, to be honest. I actually do see him having financial fulfillment. And so he's always going to be in a good place financially. I feel like, though, the main things that he's going to have to overcome are struggles with kind of like sometimes getting into his imagination and reaching for goals that are not realistic, meaning like maybe wanting to have like a hit movie, right? Like to get a part in a big movie film and have millions of dollars, and that would be financial security for him. And then he gives up and doesn't focus on anything else. For him to be stimulated on a very professional level and mental level, his soul will have to continuously be involved in different work, and maybe two or three projects at the same time. Keeping himself busy will help him. I also feel like he is kind of like a mini daredevil. Maybe we don't see that too much on the TV, but outside, but he could be like a daredevil and take risks. He needs to be careful with that, specifically with riding bikes. I don't know if he does that, you know, riding bikes, kind of driving fast, being very careful with that. But I do feel like everything's positive for him. It's just that there's a lot of conflict with his love life, okay? So that's the reading. I know it's not long reading, but, you know, readings don't have to be long to get the points that I wanted to get across. So I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, let me know what you think. Who do you think is going to be the winner of the Bachelor season 24? I think it's season 24. But let me know in the comment section. If you did like this video, please subscribe to my channel by hitting that red subscribe button on the bottom right hand corner of the video, and also hit the notification bell icon, the one that says all, so that way you'll be notified of all notifications when I publish something new. And also don't forget to smash the like button. Like I said, blessings and love and light. Have an amazing day or night wherever you are in the world.